Wow, we have very important developments surrounding the case of WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange and, of course, Chelsea Manning, the whistleblower. All important cases of free speech. But, of course, many times you won't know that as the mainstream media tries to vilify Julian Assange and others for skateboarding or leaving dirty dishes. No, that's not an exaggeration. We're going to get into this plus a lot more in this video. But before we do, just know that we are an independent free media outlet providing you content because of you and your support. Without it, we would not exist. So I want to thank everyone who goes to wearechange.org/donate and supports us for as little as $5 a month. We try to do creative content just for you. We do engagement with just you, and it means the world to us. Now, let's get to this important case because, Jason, this is not surprising to us, but surprising to a lot of people, as today we are finding out that Julian Assange has been convicted to 50 weeks, double the standard, double of what was recommended, 50 weeks in a British prison because of allegedly jumping bail. And as we know, the story is a lot more convoluted than just jumping bail. We know that Julian Assange also faces separate charges and probably even more charges that we even know about that are not even on the record from, of course, the United States with the Trump administration trying to extradite him. But first of all, let's talk about this. 50 weeks for jumping bail. I mean, WikiLeaks tweeted, quote, Julian Assange's sentencing is as shocking as it is vindictive. We have grave concerns as to whether he will receive a fair extradition hearing in the UK. And I believe those concerns are very warranted because, again, WikiLeaks tweeted another time here saying, quote, Julian Assange's sentence for seeking and receiving asylum is twice as much as the sentencing guidelines. This so-called speedboat killer convicted of manslaughter was only sentenced to 6 months for failing to appear in court. And this brings up a very important aspect here. Twice the legal sentencing guidelines, and for what they accuse of skipping a hearing, but ultimately he was skipping an unfair legal proceeding against him that was trying to take him out because he was doing reporting. He was publishing information that governments didn't want him to. That's what he was escaping. He wasn't escaping a fair hearing, in my opinion, Jason.
You know, how dare somebody who's literally being dragged through the mud in the media, politically persecuted on a level most people will never know, how dare he seek asylum when a trumped-up charge comes his way? And then, after he spends, 7 years, a little bit more than half a decade, in what is essentially a room where he dared to skateboard, Luke, and have some dirty dishes once in a while, and then drug out like an animal. How dare he? Let's give him 50 weeks. This is 2 weeks shy of a year. And if he has to serve this, Luke, since he'll be serving all day and night in jail, he'll actually be serving more time than notorious minor abuser, we'll call him that, Jeffrey Epstein, who served 13 months and was allowed to essentially go and leave as he pleased, as 12 hours a day he left the jail. So somebody who was supposed to be looking at a minimum of 360 years, who did 13 months at a vacay spot where he was allowed to leave, that guy, he's running around. Julian Assange hasn't been able to step on anybody's soil in 7 years. He's drug out of an embassy, and now he'll be going to prison for almost a year because he was being politically persecuted. And honestly, that's if he's lucky, because yeah. Luke, on Thursday, his extradition hearing to the United States comes up, and what if they play ball and they just send him right over? What are your thoughts on that?
Well, he's definitely not getting the Jeffrey Epstein treatment. As we saw Hillary Clinton kind of laugh and sinisterly enjoy the fact that the Trump administration was going after him so heavy-handedly, and they're throwing the book at him. They're not only throwing the book at him in the United Kingdom, they're going to do the same in the United States, where, of course, we had secret grand jury indictments, but there is even believed to be more secret grand jury indictments that have now put away Chelsea Manning, an important whistleblower in this country, an important person to WikiLeaks, is in jail because of that particular case. But before we jump into Chelsea Manning and what just happened with her hearing, because we were there on the ground when she was going in, but Julian Assange also released the letter saying, quote, I did what I thought at the time was the best or perhaps the only thing that I could have done. Again, apologizing, saying that he's apologizing to those who considered he's disrespected them. That's a big kind of talking point that they're doing here. And again, they're talking about so many little nuances here that it absolutely makes no sense at all. They're throwing the book at him. That's exactly what's happening here. He's been sentenced right now to what is essentially close to 1 year. It's 2 weeks shy of 1 year. But me and Jason have been talking, and me and Jason are saying, hey, he's probably never going to see the light of day because of everything that's happening. And here's video of him that the media is playing. They showed Dirty Dishes. They showed him riding around on a skateboard as literally for years, he was stuck in one room. And this is what they have. This is what they have to vilify him as some sort of dangerous, crazy criminal that has to be locked up away. How dare he seek asylum when he knew everything was being unfairly, every rule was being broken just to punish him for publishing information that, of course, governments did not want him to publish. That's what the story is all about. It's about free speech. It's about the press. I'm watching that footage and it's like, come on, really? That's all you have on him from all those years?
Luke, how dare he try to impress a girl as he's locked up in a room in an embassy with 4 feet of square space to use his skateboard. You can't even do an ollie in there. I mean, come on, man. This poor guy. And that's the best they got? You know, there's a little juicier footage afterwards, but I'm sure it's out of context. Again, it's clear he was politically persecuted. Remember at the end there, Luke, they cut him off from the internet as well. There was a time where, yeah, he was stuck in there, but he was at least giving lectures and interactive speeches at colleges and other events. So we could actually hear from him. And, you know, I found that his last broadcast that you could only find on Ruptly, you know, I have to go to the Russian media to actually see what this man is saying in context. He said some really interesting and eye-opening things. And I actually found one from about 2 years ago where he said some things about 9/11 that I'd never heard him say that were also very eye-opening. So, you know, it's sad that the media, establishment politicians like Hillary Clinton and others are celebrating this man's downfall and trying to get him extradited into the United States. It's even sadder that this country elected somebody who ran on a campaign of loving the WikiLeaks. And then when the nitty-gritty came down, he said, WikiLeaks, I don't know about it. It's not my thing.
Yeah, you could see Hillary Clinton reveling in pleasure with the news and an announcement, laughing, smiling, being so upbeat and happy. Meanwhile, what happened to Donald Trump's, who literally came from I Love WikiLeaks, lock her up, to I don't know who that is. What is wrong with, like, that's the one of the biggest back turns against incredibly important issues. And of course, people like, you know, Julian Assange, Chelsea Manning, they're not perfect individuals. I bet you could probably criticize them on a couple things. You could criticize other people, but they stand for a bigger representation of ideas. Chelsea Manning, again, was a major whistleblower, saw some things that she did not like. She sent it to WikiLeaks. WikiLeaks published it. Because of that, she did significant jail time. She is back in jail after, of course, she had a very significant sentence. Barack Obama commuted that sentence. She was let go. She was let free. According officially to the law, she did her time, right? According to the law, according to many people. Even a larger subsection who said she should have never been in jail in the first place. But that's a whole nother discussion to be had. She's back in jail right now. Why? Because of these superseding grand jury secret indictments that are going after Assange. She was called to testify. She refused to testify. And because they locked her in, a portion of that was in solitary confinement, which of course creates very serious mental issues and many people see as a form of torture. Well, she just had another hearing where, of course, she tried to amend and tried to appeal this decision. The court this Monday rejected her appeal. And she will still be in jail for the remainder of this hearing for contempt to not testifying before this grand jury, of course, against Julian Assange, against, of course, these new charges that Donald Trump's Department of Justice is bringing up against the WikiLeaks founder. So again, Thursday is the case. He's going to have to sit off the rest of the time in the United Kingdom. It's going to be interesting to see what happened, but it's going to be long legal proceedings. We're here for a while. We're going to be here for a while, guys. So we're going to be updating you as much as we can, but expect these trials to go on for a significant time. They're going to go on a while in the United Kingdom. They're going to go a while in the United States. But it's important not to forget these stories because they're bigger representations of free speech, of the rights of media being able to get documents and publish them. That's what this is all about. It's about journalism. It's about muckraking. It's about whistleblowing. It's about telling the truth when a system of power failed us and is doing something immoral and wrong. This is what this story is all about. Sure, Assange, Manning, not perfect individual. We could criticize them on so many levels, but tell me that the story is about something else. And it's going to be very hard to convince me. Try to in the comments. I'm very curious. That's all I have to say. Jason, anything else you want to say about this? And should we close it off here?
Yeah, I just want to remind people that when they say they're extraditing Assange, they're also saying that he assisted in the hacking. This isn't about publishing documents, all lies. He assisted in the hacking by encouraging Manning to find the password. That's not assisting in hacking. That's not what this is about. It's all lies based upon lies, based upon lies, so that they can send that chilling effect to other journalists saying, hey, you better not publish these things even if you get them. That being said, we are doing 4 videos a day across 2 platforms, 3 on the backup, 1 on the main. Please subscribe to both Pulse Change and We Are Change. Ring that bell for notifications. The mean streets of YouTube are tough. We need you to share this stuff out on the social media, in the blog posts, on the Reddit, in the vote, everywhere you can. And we need you to get out there and be the change you want to see in the world.